today's episode, I'm back with another interesting recipe that I'm pretty sure you're going to love it once you try it out. We are making some beetroot chapatis, and with me here, I have my usual ingredients. I have some all-purpose flour, I have some salt, and I have some cooking oil. So if at all you like adding sugar to your chapatis, well and good. I'm going to be adding just a small pinch because of the beetroot as you extract its juice, and so that it can also tone down on the acidity of the beetroot. The beetroot is slightly acidic. It's not acidic, it's just a mild acidic. So I'm going to be getting rid of that with some sugar. And finally, I have some water. This is some tap water. And without further ado, let's get started. First things first, I'm going to start by extracting the color from the beetroots. And you can either blend your beetroot or you can also grate it. I'm going to be blending mine for today's recipe, but if at all you do not have a blender, you can also use a grater. Also, to get rid of the mild acidity from the beetroot, you can also boil it first before blending it, but I'm not going to be doing that in today's episode, maybe in another episode. So this is a good size that my blender can handle. Then I'm just going to go in with a small pinch of sugar, some water. Then I'm going to blend this. So this is what I have, and I'm going to go about how I usually cook my chapatis. But I'm first going to sieve the pulp to make sure that there are no huge lumps. Then I'm going to add the pulp in the dough. So you can either decide to use the water alone, or you can also use the water and the pulp.